mantras are like medication. Mantra is a sacred, powerful, sensitive vibration. Namaste everyone, I am Chandresh Bhardwaj and today I'll be sharing if a mantra can harm you. Let's take example of cough syrup, you know, that we take to cure any itch, any congestion, any problem in your, you know, breathing, in your throat. If you are unwell, that syrup will help you. Maybe one spoon for a consistent few nights and you'll be fine. But what if you start to take it only because you start to like it? Maybe it's giving you deep sleep. Maybe you just like the taste of it. Maybe you like how it can numb down the body. Then it becomes a little complicated, right? Another take on this, let's say you have perfect throat and you simply go to pharmacy to buy the cough syrup because all your friends are doing it. And you're like, everyone is taking it. Maybe I should also take it. Another take is, you go to pharmacy store, you're just hanging out and you're like, this pink syrup looks good. It's for throat, I'll take it. And you start taking it. The point is, mantras are like medication. Mantra is a sacred, powerful, sensitive vibration. It must be done consciously. It must be done under expert, careful guidance. When people ask me, what's your favorite mantra? Or when they tell me, I do this mantra because I like it. Do you ever say this about your medicines? I take this medicine because I like it. Or what's your favorite medicine? We don't say that. We take medicine when we are unwell, when we need that. You know, mantra is like a cab you order because you need to go from your home to airport. And when you reach airport, you get out of the cab and you take the flight. You don't keep sitting in the cab, right? Or you won't order the cab if you don't want to go to the airport. This is how a mantra is supposed to be. It takes you from point A to B. You only take it when you need it. There are no favorite mantras. You're not supposed to like your mantras. You're not supposed to build any infatuation with them. I feel the modern spiritual narrative creates this romantic relationship with mantras. And people are chanting mantras without knowing the signs, without knowing why they're doing it. It's the herd mentality. Because everyone is doing it, I'm also going to do it. And when you read a book or two about mantra, you feel, I know it all, and now I'm going to do every mantra in the book. You could pick the greatest mantra in the greatest book of mantras, and that will harm you if you are simply doing it unconsciously. I may be going through stress or anxiety, and if I open the book of mantras and it says this is a good mantra for anxiety, that doesn't make it right for me to do the mantra, because there are thousands of mantras for anxiety. What if that mantra will calm down your anxiety but increase your aggression on some other level? Because that happens all the time. So the point is, when you do the mantras, learn about them, discuss with your teachers, and only then go into it. Take the mantras based on your chakra alignment, your intentions, your family history, your cultural conditioning. It could take easily 2 to 3 months to even arrive at the right mantra, and that's by someone who knows what they're doing. It's a sensitive path. Do not treat it casually. And above all, as you start to do the mantra, repeat them consciously. Get into them gently and consciously. And the safest mantra that I can give you in this video is Soham Namaha. The mantra simply says, I am awareness. I am aware of my awareness. But even this mantra, I recommend do it for 5 to 7 minutes. If you meditate for 1 hour, 5 minutes of mantra is good. This one. If you are getting direct mantra from me, that will have a completely different guideline. But if you choose to do Soham Namaha, do it for, you know, 10-20 minutes in a much longer meditation. And if you meditate for only 20 minutes, 3 to 4 minutes of Soham is good enough. I hope this video resonates with you. I hope it answers your doubts about mantra. If you are interested in going deeper, what a mantra is, how the meditation and mantras can blend and work well, I invite you to explore Leela Gurukul. It's an online spiritual school and where lots of students are learning the depth of mantra, healing and spirituality. And as always, to support this channel, share this video, subscribe to the channel and drop some comments and your questions. Thank you.